on the topic of the ye olden backyard, I figure we should probably do that before we spend 99% of our stream shooting people, which, you know, is not a bad way to spend a stream. Backyard got posted. This is all, you know, chat. This is all nonsense. Here's Goldie Dickums, and they're just like, hey, this is what he does, this is how he works, security level, make some noise. Not probably the most important bit of the backyard, right? We get past that. What to call Goldlewis? Now, I also thought this part was useless, but I know some of you care. Is Goldlewis the guy eating a hamburger in the backyard of the stage and Exord sign? That's his brother. They ain't making this shit up. These motherfuckers are like, we'll just say it's his brother. Somebody call Wooly. I need a fact check on this. I don't buy it for a goddamn minute. The important parts. Battle balance adjustments. We plan to release an update with battle adjustments during the latter half of August. Who could have seen this coming? Your favorite influencers are like, guys, trust me, when Goldlewis comes out, they're going to take Soul's hands away. And they're going to make RAM forget her swords at home. And May is going to be in a troubled relationship with the Dolphins. She will no longer be able to summon them in battle like Ash and Charizard. Obviously, you know, it didn't happen. Much more likely that the patch comes later after the character in August, right? That makes way more sense considering, you know, Evo's happening. It's, what, 2 months after? So it's like 3 months after now instead. This is a part of a two-step adjustment we're looking into by having another update around October. You'd love to see it. That gives you a timeline, right? So if you're a competitive player or if you're a player just playing the game, you know when to expect updates or how long your character is going to be the same. So this might line up around the other character, or it could just be, you know, before or after, who knows. In the late August update, the one coming this month, our main goals are strengthening the characters we've determined to be lacking in power and improving moves that don't have enough options for use. We plan to pinpoint the changes we make to specific targets rather than making overall changes. That means some characters will remain unchanged. The first thing that came to mind when I saw this was that I like this idea because there are characters that have moves that are not doing enough. Like Soul, he needs his 2D to low profile like it used to. And his 2S, it used to be plus, and in this game, it's not really that good. So I was like, dude, that's what I'm fucking talking about, brother. I was like, dude, finally. Some fucking good buffs for Soul. That's what I've been asking for. But really, I think this is cool. The idea to target strengthening characters that they think need it. Some strong characters might not get touched, and then some characters that are weaker might not get a ton of love, but specific targeted things on moves that they want to be better, which I think is a really interesting way to do it. Because some characters are just like, why would I hit this button? Or why, you know, what am I trying to do with this special move? Or what am I trying to do with this? Like, I don't really have a point to use it, right? And that feels bad, especially in a game like Gear. Situationally, almost every move in some matchup or in some way has a, you know, a particular use. We are considering changes to damage output or minor adjustments to the properties of overwhelmingly powerful characters and moves. However, we will make these decisions very carefully. This sounds like, hey, we know clean hit DP does a lot of damage. We hear you that we don't like how much this does when Risk's cranked. I would imagine there's a couple of things that they have in mind to change, but it sounds like their overall plan is to increase the strength of moves or characters they think are underperforming and make only slight adjustments to super powerful characters. They say, with the second update, we plan to make detailed and overall adjustments to improve the depth and fun of the game. We'd like to address the details of this at another time. However, as a general plan, our number one priority is to make controlling the characters and player matches more fun. This is a really interesting statement because the first update, they're like, this isn't going to be some drastic overhaul, right? The second update, they're like, we want to improve the depth and fun of the game. So it sounds like a grander, broader update, right? Maybe some system changes will be there, and maybe they're more interested in drastically changing things, or maybe some characters will get new moves or something, right? The second patch sounds like the big, like, okay, this is more likely to have system stuff and more likely to be a large update to the overall balance of the game. That is very interesting, and it's not that far away either. A lot of people have been asking for more meter usages, right? Like more 25% meter usage. I think more meter in general would be nice to have. It's also pretty nasty. Every time someone has meter, I just think, all right, something really fucked up's about to happen, and I'm gonna try to survive it. Force breaks? Oh no, they're back. Give me force break Fafnir. That's like 10 frames and plus 20. Hell yeah. What if Ram threw both swords at the same time? Force break sword toss. She just throws both. Just boom, and they come back like a yo-yo. Force break far slash? It's called 6S, bro. Come on, it's already in the game. Make YRC 25%. 25% YRC would make defense really, really good, I think, though. I'm going to be honest with you. I don't think defense is that bad in this game. I don't think the defensive options are as weak as people try to make them out to be. I will clarify. Guilty Gear is not a game where you're supposed to just block for forever. In a game like Dragon Ball, right? That's sort of a viable plan of attack. You can just kind of hold out and you'll be fine. In this game, first of all, you're not supposed to do that, and that's probably not correct, right? And second of all, I don't think the defense is that bad most of the time. I know the window is small in IV, but I think people underutilize it. It's easy to just be like, the timing is too hard, I'm not doing it. But I don't know, I think it's very useful. And I think FD is only really bad against certain characters' moves. Like, any stagger pressure is not really that weak to FD, but as soon as you commit to something, FD is very useful. IB can get you blown the fuck up if you miss it. Yeah, I mean, usually if you're trying to IB something and you are successful, you will punish or stop their pressure, right? So, you know, if you're wrong, yeah, you should probably take some damage. If the window is wide, like much wider, 1 frame, 2 frame, 3 frames more, offense in the game becomes very weak because so much of the pressure in this game is negative enough that if you IB it, it's punishable. You just point blank like, well, I guess I'm dead. There's so many character like moves in the game that are -7 that if you IB, you punish with close slash. They say, in addition, we will continue to address unintended issues of the game separate from the schedule above. We've avoided making adjustments that would impact battle balance until late August. However, we are aware that the effects of some bugs have impacted Zato Eddie's move. These are so funny, the Zato bugs, where he like gets stuck and moving around the screen. I wonder what their plan of attack is for stuff like the PRC stuff. It comes up, like the super PRC invincibility, it's gonna come up. I think that's what they're talking about later on. They say, while we intend to address each bug in a timely manner, we may keep in some of the unintended effects were found if we determine they make the game more fun. I think that this is what they're talking about here, maybe. There's replay data bugs. This has been happening since the Goldlewis patch. I've heard a lot of people talk about this, right? We will be fixing this bug within the month. That's nice. We're also working on making improvements to the play environment in each mode, including offline modes, to address issues such as the connection to the server upon launching the game. Make some noise. Taking a long time outside of Asia, as well as network errors occurring during lobby and player matches. Hell yeah. All right, so on to the questions. We already talked about Goldlewis's brother. Made up. I don't buy it. I like that this question as well about music. They say, while additional songs will be added for future playable characters, any other music additions are being looked into with consideration for each circumstance. We have received requests to add the additional tracks from the Korean version of Reload. The Korean OST is very good. We're also looking at adding themes of characters who are not playable in GGST from prior series titles. Yeah, there's some missing, right? Robokai theme? All right, no. Never mind. This is a mistake. We've also received requests to adjust the volume balance for individual songs, as well as the option for random selection between songs registered as favorites. That's a really good idea. We can only say that we will be looking into this next for now. However, we will continue working to approach an ideal implementation via future updates. It's cool that they mention these because they're like, yeah, we know you guys are talking about it. Anyway, they say, hey, if you guys want to submit questions and stuff, you can submit questions and take a survey and all that kind of stuff. I'm really excited for the changes in October. I'm really curious about what they're going to do. It's also nice to know that we have two balance patches coming, right? So you don't have to like sit there and think, is this game ever going to get patched? Like, when's it going to get patched? I've played a lot of games that have been patched frequently, chat, and I'll tell you what, sometimes you really don't want patches to be incredibly frequent. In Mortal Kombat X, I flew to a tournament, a balance patch came out, and it was not on the version of the game I played until I was already flying to a tournament, and when I landed, I was watching videos of my character's new B&Bs because my main string that I used in combos, it couldn't cancel anymore. I got off of a plane to play in tournament and none of my B&Bs worked anymore. I actually just changed characters. I think I went back to a different character whose B&Bs didn't change or something. Yeah, I mean, KI also had monthly patches. That was a very hectic thing to live through because, you know, every month a new character would drop and there'd be a patch. Not all the patches were huge, but it was like pretty dramatic sometimes that stuff was just changed. You know, if you hadn't played in like a month or two or a couple weeks and a patch had come out, it's pretty different.
Listen.
Make Rin guard crush? All right, keep it down. I'm not trying to hear a balance suggestion from chat ever again. I don't remember asking you a goddamn thing. Make Rin guard crush? No. Not if your life depended on it, no. Hell no. You motherfucking Anji players want to do Fujin and literally nothing. You're like, I would like to Fujin and then not ever do anything else or think about anything else in the game ever. I hate it here.